Thank you.
Thank you, Siri.
Okay. Condoleezza Rice, this one
here.
Condoleezza Rice. Condoleezza Rice. Condoleezza, very nice. Condoleezza Rice with jam on top. With a little sprinkle of cinnamon on top. Condoleezza Rice with a bit of brown sugar. Yeah, brown sugar. She took me upstairs to give me a rub down. Brown sugar. She had ginger hair. Don't know why they called her brown sugar. Brown sugar. 22 stars.
Stop it, just keep going.
While I was walking up this hill, it was sunny and still in Morley. When I came across this skip at the top of this hill in Morley. It was the middle of the day, there was no one else around. They all must have been playing golf ball down at fucking M&S. And there's something about a skip that sets my juices flowing. When I put it in my bag, I thought, that's for me. There were a few felt tips and a plastic sword. Stuck deep in the muck, I thought, I'll leave Excalibur for someone else. And I drew it out carefully. It had folk songs of Morley written on the side in biro. I thought, now that looks quite intriguing, and I was sort of tantalised. There was the hairs were going up on the fucking neck. 'Cause opportunity knocked, and I'd been ready. To this
song. I've got it now, you ready? Listen. Well, I firmly believe there's a place in this world for all that flies, swims and sits. But I would have preferred folk songs of Morley to Brian Ferry's greatest hits. You know, I can't see because the light's too bright. I'm just looking in that direction.
Sorry.
Picasso was a Russian Jew. He lived in a cottage by the side of a lake. He took a lot of mushrooms. He sold them in the market. And everybody called him the Mushroom Man. To keep his spirits up. He had a secret that he shared with a woman, Urania. He should have kept his mouth shut. He should have kept quiet. He didn't turn up on market day. There wasn't much fuss. No one asked too many questions. He didn't really mix. Kept himself to himself. A bit of a loner. The Mushroom Man. Couple of weeks, still no sign of him. A few of the locals went to check it out. The cottage was empty. Had he gone away? Not a sight, not a sound of the Mushroom Man. And a rusty old rat trap. They both scratch their heads. Now they both share the cottage. But it's just for a short while. They'll not stay long. And the mushrooms are growing. growing out in the backyard, and people still remember the mushroom.